Hello, this is an update to the previous video which provided guidance to users deleting rows based on empty or zero values. I will use the original formatted data which will overcome an oversight that the original macro had. In this example, this updated macro will be able to delete rows of data even if they are at the bottom of the dataset. Let's compose our revised macro. It is best practice to add option explicit at the top of the module because it will force us to declare the variables for each specific macro. We will call this macro deleteZeroRows. Remember to disable the following Excel properties. Next, we will declare specific variables for this macro. The looping piece of the macro can now be added. This line of code is the major change, because the macro will loop through the data based on the data in column B. It will then identify if the corresponding cell in column J is empty or contains a zero before deciding to delete the entire row. As the above narrative explains, this piece of code will identify rows of code based on the value in column J that are zero or blank. Whilst the next line of code will delete the entire row if the cell in column J is in fact zero or blank. The macro will now move the cursor to the next row of data. Once the macro has cycled through all the rows, we will move the cursor back to the top of the worksheet in cell A1. The macro has completed its task. It is now time to re-enable those three Excel properties which were disabled to improve the speed of the macro. The macro is complete. Let's review the code before we try it out on the dataset. We will now run the macro. We will assign the new updated macro to the macro button. As we can see, the macro has successfully deleted rows of data which contain blank or zero cells in column J, even at the bottom of the dataset.